Bit of a surprise on this one. The head coach of Temple Albury, it's Gavin!
Everybody, we are now back live, and we have Gavin Stewart versus James Dorman. Oh, this is the match I've been waiting for. We've got Gavin Stewart in the green at Tent Planet.
So this is a rematch from a previously lost match from Gav. So we're going straight down into the lock guard position, working for that underhook.
Yeah, this is smart from Gavin. He's going straight to his Tent Planet skills set there, pulling half guard, getting that lockdown.
Yeah,
he's going to look for
his home.
Right underhook, and he's going to try and scoot out at the back. But James Dorman, a very experienced black belt, he's going to be very aware of this.
Yeah.
He's been fighting that underhook and then trying to undo that lockdown he's got on his right leg. Gavin doing the right thing. He's trying to scoot on, but James also doing the right thing. He's blocking that underhook, blocking Gavin from pulling that leg on top of his shoulder.
And you can just feel the atmosphere in the room has changed.
Yeah, it is tense now. Everyone's watching these black belts. And sometimes it can be a much slower game with much high-level competitors because it's all about the millimeters, it's all about this tiny adjustment.
Yeah.
Like right here, they're literally, it's all about who can get a slightly better underhook grip. Can James Dorman just cross-face, flatten Gavin out? Can Gavin get under with his right arm and try and whip him up just like that? This is what Gavin wants. Dorman does a good job of dropping back down, staying safe. He's got to start dealing with that lockdown on his leg. Here we go. Gavin's doing a really good job keeping that left arm under hook. It's keeping him safe. Oh, Dorman out of the lockdown, standing up. Going to have a bit more of a wrestling match.
Yeah, back to the feet now. It'll be interesting to see what happens here.
Yeah, we'll grab pull guard again. We'll see James possibly looking for a takedown. Really interesting chess game. It's a slightly different posture to like a wrestling match because you have to be constantly aware of someone dropping down, looking for leg entries. Oh, Gavin used that beautifully to come up on top. James got the single butterfly hook.
Gavin's a very big fan of very heavy pressure passing, so I'm sure he's going to be happy in this position.
Yeah, and you can see that he's taking his time. This is the black belt level. This is the experience coming through. He's sitting back, controlling the hips, stopping James Dorman from getting an angle.
Yeah. Keeping his posture, taking his time.
Yeah. And James is doing a great job trying to affect that posture. He's using his right hand, trying to pull him down. He's controlling one of Gav's wrists as well. Some people really like the single butterfly hook position. It's really great for setting up sweeps.
Mm.
If he's trying to get the sweep, he's going to need to control Gavin's left arm. Gavin steps through, ends up in half guard.
Yeah, nice advance in that half guard position well there.
You can see every Tent Planet person does this. They get in half guard, they hide their heel because they don't want a lockdown.
Yeah.
It's absolutely. Just instinct at this point.
And he's got the far side arm there.
Yeah, and it's all about the underhook on that arm that Gavin's attacking. If James can get a nice left-handed underhook, he's going to be safe. And he uses the space to explode, make space.
Gav did well to block the sweep there.
Gavin trying to get through the brief knee shield guard. Hooking that leg with his hand, it's unusual. Goes back to that position. And you see Gavin, his right arm is controlling the left arm of James Dorman. It's all about that underhook. When you've got the half guard, the side that you've trapped the leg, that underhook, the battle is for that. Whoever's winning is basically whoever's got that underhook. And they're both not giving it up.
Yeah.
James Dorman trying to make space, using the forearm in the face.
Yeah, and Gav's going to be happy. I think he's going to take his time. You'll see. I like patient approach to the pass of the last leg that's trapped.
Yeah, I like what he's doing as well. He's sitting back on the hips. You kind of got two options. You can try and control the head, or you can try and control the hips. At the moment, he's just looking to control the hips. But Dorman does a good job of getting control. Gavin uses the pass.
Nice pass.
Beautiful little back step.
He's chosen to wrap that head, keeping those hips nice and flat.
And like we said before, they've had a match previously. How will that affect James Dorman? He's previously got the win.
Looks Gavin's like Gav's working for a north-south choke there.
Yeah, that.
See if we can get that lap to the side of his head there.
Nice! Yeah. Beautiful! What a submission! In his gym, in front of his students, against someone that previously beat him. Does it get this? A fairy tale story right there.
That is absolutely unbelievable. And that is textbook Gavin Stewart Jiu Jitsu.
What a monster.
Really patient passing, got into side control, yeah. And then wrapped that head. He knew exactly what he wanted as soon as he wrapped that head. I didn't want to say it out loud, but that north south, he is an absolute killer with that.
Very tight as well. Very, very tight indeed. Got it. I love that. Love that. Excellent, excellent work there from Gavin Stewart against the very talented James Dorman.